music of Ariana Grande with Imagine. 5:37 is the time on our to your station of choice. We, of course, get right on to the segment Empowering Your Vision on our to your station of choice. And Kenali Mompoloki Makwana. Morning.
Hi, good morning, Zandile. I hope you're doing so well. It has been a wonderful, great week. And I had an amazing weekend. This weekend I was at Kopalape leading some sessions there. How was your weekend?
My weekend was... Wow! How was my weekend? Wow, it was okay. I was home with family. My weekend was nice, yeah.
All right.
Sean today is not in.
Okay.
I don't know.
Yes.
But let's just get on to the topic of discussion. We're talking about self-regulation.
Yes, self-regulation.
Okay.
I think in short terms, it talks about self-control.
Mm-hmm.
Today, our thought of the day, you see, is from John Wooden.
Okay.
John Wooden was one of the greatest basketball coach and a teacher. He taught English.
Okay.
And one thing that he did that to his kids that he was teaching, he never talked about success. He talked about you as a person. You can succeed if you control yourself. Other things, they are outside of your control. Imagine, 4 months ago, we didn't know about the coronavirus.
Yeah.
And it just came now, and it's a world epidemic thing.
Mm.
So is that we don't have control over everything in the outside, but we can control ourselves, and as we regulate ourselves, we are ultimately be able to survive or thrive. Yeah,
very, very true.
Yeah.
Let's just get to I don't know, you didn't say the thought of the day.
Yeah, I didn't say the thought of the day.
Yes.
I talked about the person who said the thought of the day.
Yes.
He said, if you lose self-control, everything will fall. If you lose self-control, everything will fall. Everything is steady right now where you are.
Mm.
Your family, your business, your finances, your social life is steady because you are able to control yourself. When we lose ourselves, everything else around us will fall.
I think it explains itself. If
yes.
you lose your momentum,
yeah.
everything just slacks. Everything falls down. All right, let's get to the first point. Always seek clarity. Operate from clarity and not assumptions. Mm.
it's a very powerful one.
It hits home.
It is very, very powerful.
Very, very.
This weekend, I was leading a session on conflict management.
Oh.
I do that for employees in different organizations.
Mm.
And what I said to them was, you know, normally conflict comes from the inside of us.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about the other person, it's about us.
Yeah.
I told them that sometimes, you know, have you ever received a text from someone and you were so boiling up, you have blocked them on social media within that 10 minutes of the text you received,
yeah.
and you're already telling other people, "Hak about wale tskabala marketing." Only to go and meet the person about it. This is what I meant.
Mm.
And that understanding from what they were saying changes everything.
Yeah.
When I also can do this silly hella because of your own internal issues.
Mm.
And you related the outside text, it's on go a friend, with what you are dealing with. Having nothing to do with what you have inside of you.
Mm.
And now what happens is you were operating from assumption. And your assumption, you know, temporary assumptions were making you to leading you to make permanent decisions.
Mm-hmm.
And so many people today, Zandile, are struggling right now because they took one temporary issue and they made permanent, you know, decisions out of that.
Mm.
And their life is not going to the direction they want. And they wonder, how can I change? Why me, God? Because they were operating from assumptions and not from clarity.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you want to share something in there.
To me, it goes back to the thought of it the day.
Yes.
Which talks of if you lose self-control, everything falls.
Yep.
Everything falls down. And here, when it says, Jorge, always seek clarity, always try to understand what is this person trying to say.
Yeah.
Because if I tell you that I see this thing this way, it may not be the way you see it.
Yeah.
It may not be the way you hear it, you know?
It's
necessary for you to always understand the perspective ya motho o mongwe gore o ra yang ntlhalosetse
yeah
ya no how that the when you continue to say operate from clarity and not assumption now that it also speaks of self control
yeah
it also you know gives one person a power to understand that you know what you need to understand that what you think may yeah. not necessarily be what the other person is thinking.
True.
Always try as much as possible to try and understand what the next person is trying to say rather than you assuming. And assumptions, they bring a lot of, I don't know, insecurities.
Yeah, they do.
To them. So it's better you know, ask.
You clear
things up before you know have that mind block in
and the other thing that I want to share there about assumptions is that what most people do if Zandile said something the clarity you are seeking is not from Mompoloki. Most people misunderstand issues because they misplace issues. If Zandile said something and you want to understand what she was talking about, go straight to Zandile and ask what she was saying. Instead of going to the next person, you cannot solve issues of two people by trying to bring the third person. And also you cannot solve issues when they involve three people with two people. You are going to multiply your assumptions. If you are supposed to ask Zandile onoring, it becomes multiplication of misunderstandings.
Because
we are different. Yeah. Now we are dealing with three people who are having issues now to Zandile instead of two. So clarity, you know, paves, you know, a way to success because once we are sure of what people mean, what other people, the way they understand issues, and we are able to sit down and say, okay, I understand what you meant. Even at our workplaces, you know, there is so much of misunderstandings when there is no clarity of roles, who is doing what. In business partnerships, normally we go with friends into let's form a business, and along the way, millions come in, and now the other one is not putting in the work. The other one is putting in the work. We don't have clarity of roles on paper to say when I would say laha company tena billions, multi-billions. How CEO? Turago is an operational manager. Now, without those now, people end up fighting and families right now. The issue of December, what hampu is in the December. Now we are carrying the 2016 December issue to 2020 December issue. So clarity is very important and key to seeking it immediately after you hear and after you don't understand. Immediately seek clarification because what the mind does is this: it multiplies with thoughts, it builds issues inside of you. Because inside of you now you are relating that seven to so many other issues that has nothing to do with what is happening on the ground.
All right.
Yeah.
Do not take things personal. Issues elevate when they are personalized. If issues elevate when they are personalized, do not take things personal.
What do you think about that? What do you think about that? That
so I think this, to me, it just goes to how we need to understand that it's not not everything is about us.
It's not always about you.
It's not always about you.
Yeah.
We have a problem of victimizing ourselves.
True.
That is just how it is. That's just how we are as people. And when it says, do not take things personal, you not taking things personal, it gives you a peace of mind. It, you know, it eases your thoughts. You don't overthink about a lot of things that you should not be even thinking about at that moment.
True.
You know? And then issues elevate when they're personalized. Obviously, issues will definitely heighten, they will definitely enlarge, they will definitely, you know, be huge if at all you start thinking, oh, that person you start even looking at critical high and worry. So that it's not one of two kind of motto when Nasak and you saw an Osaka and see.
Exactly.
BP lo neve, okay, say.
And Maluetia, I'll get there.
Tiny things, you know, they increase because Malawi, we talked about how, you know, one step leads to another.
Yeah.
this basically does that. You know, if you take things personal, they lead to this, they lead to this. You even become a bitter person.
True.
Because you are personalizing things. You think everyone is always in your back for some reason. I don't know. Do you have something to say about this one?
I think you really covered it so well that when we understand that when people say things, it's not about us, it helps you to be in a position, when we say peace of mind, it helps you to be in a position to discuss issues and not yourself.
Mm.
Because when everything is tabled up, when topics are tabled up, let's take an example, issues of religion, issues of politics. You know why people fight when talk about that? It's because now when we are talking about politics, they're talking about their party.
Yeah.
We're not talking about the religion, they're talking about their church.
Yeah.
So we can no longer have conversations. I remember by the time I did top, right? So now when we don't personalize things, we engage our intellectual thinking.
Mm.
When you don't personalize things, we engage our intellectual thinking.
Uh-huh.
But when we personalize things, we become petty.
Very
you know,
true.
Because we are saying, I'm going to say it this way so that it suits my circumstance.
Mm.
I'm going to put the question this way so that at the end of the day, they see that I am intelligent. Now, you are wasting everyone's time.
Yeah.
You already know about the phenomena.
Yeah.
Now, we can discuss something else about which can go, we can move us to the next level. We see this in organizations, we see this in businesses where people are not really saying the things that can bring progress, but they are saying things that can put them in the enlightened way. Have you ever seen a CSR that is corporate social responsibility, the way nowadays is done? It's no longer about, okay, we are going to help. It's, oh, we are helping so that we put
look
on social
us.
Media.
Yes,
so it's
us.
You
yeah.
personalize things. So we cannot be able to make real progress when it's all about us.
Mm.
It's sometimes, you know, sit down, listen, don't say a thing. Even though it may speak like it's talking about you, it's not about you. It's about making real progress and allows other people to learn who are them. Every time you have a conversation, try this today as you are listening at home. Today, as you have a conversation, let it not always be about you.
Mm.
Understand that issues are discussed so that we can find solutions. If you know something that relates to you, it has nothing to do with you. Unless people say, according to your story and your life, how can we help us to do that? That's when we can personalize. But otherwise, so many issues are not solved because people are talking personal issues and not business issues, not organizational issues.
Very true. Let's move on to the third one. Other people's views does not define your value. Other people's views don't define your value.
You see, when this thing, this points gives to each other.
Mm.
When you are always about personalizing things,
mm.
when we are having a discussion right now, and we are not agreeing,
when
I got you are always personalizing things, how about Tubare? Yes, we agree to you. You think they're saying yes to your intellectual ability,
mm-hmm.
or you are saying they're saying yes to your talents.
Mm.
When they say no, what do you think?
You think that it's saying no to your talents. You think they're saying no to your abilities. You think they generally do not like this person.
They are disrespecting you.
Yes.
Well, so it happens now. We end up now doing what? We end up being in a position where we are saying, ah, batubar habantat.
Yeah.
It's not batubar habantat. It's what you said at that moment was not in relation to what was discussed.
Yeah.
And as we do that, we see organizations not losing people.
Yeah.
Because the research shows that, you know, most people leave their job because of their bosses.
Yeah.
Not because they don't like the work environment or not paid. People don't mind not being paid.
Yeah.
People mind when they're in an environment when they are not appreciated. Now, think of this. Maybe part of that percentage is where we are thinking people are not giving us a raise or they are not celebrating us because they don't value us. But there is nothing to do with that. There are other issues in our workplaces that are affecting what people are doing, so they don't have time to say, Tato, we saw what you did last time, we celebrate you. That sometimes people do forget. And you do forget as well.
Right.
Now, we want to hold other people to a higher standard and we don't want to hold ourselves to a higher standard.
Mm.
When it's about us, we want people to be at 100% carefulness.
Mm.
But when it's about us dealing with other people, we want people to hold us at 50%.
Mm.
So almost all the time, when people say something, they are not talking about you, like we said.
Mm.
Now, your value now is going to degrade. If you are attaching to what people are saying at the moment, people change, emotion change. We are emotional beings. Today, I may not be Mompoloki Makwana who I am to yesterday, who I was a week ago, because of my emotion and whatever that I'm facing. So saying something to you does not define your abilities and does not define your value. I like what my mentor said. He said, do not let other people's opinion of you to become your reality. Les Brown, do not let other people's opinions of you to become your reality.
That's a very nice one.
Yes. How do we move away from allowing other people to dictate our value by not listening to them? I want to, for you to chip in here. John Wooden, the who shared the thought of the day today, who said, if you lose self-control, everything will fall. You know what he did? He was known for this one thing. People, all the teams across the world, they know John Wooden, when he gets to the basketball court, he is not going to be in a defensive mode. He's going to be attacking. He taught other people his value, that when I get to the field, we are not going to be waiting to see how you are going to play, then we can attack later. When we get to the field, we are attacking you. Now, all the teams were preparing for John Wooden by defending. Now, every time they step in the court, they say, those guys, they are attacking. How do we defend? He made them mentally losing because he was in control that we are going to attack. Whether you attack us or not, we are going to attack you. That most of the time when we rise up with that attitude, that today, regardless of what people are going to say, I am going to give my 100% and 120% to my workplace. I am going to come up. I'm going to make calls. I'm going to follow up. Anyone who needs help, I'm going to rise up to the occasion. That our value begins to change when we are not waiting for the other people to define the value, but us defining the value for ourselves every morning. Yes.
Can I continue?
Yes.
Okay. The last one already. Okay. You are in control. Start building your life from the truth that you are in control.
Yes. Talk about it.
It's just... You are in control.
Yeah.
Start building your life from the truth that you are in control.
Yeah.
You just have to be, you have to understand where you are.
Yeah.
And what you're doing, wherever you are. And you know what? Stick to it. If it works, move with it. Move with it as you move with it, it also helps you to grow as a person, because one, if you are very much content with who you are and your values, it doesn't matter who comes in and says what. It really doesn't matter. The outside forces, they're there to there's no how you can change another person's view of you.
It's true. Just,
as long as you control yourself and you control your ways and your values, that's all that matters. The rest is up to the outside sources.
True.
That is just all I'm saying for now.
Yeah, that we have to understand that the universe is responding in regards to how we feel in the inside of us.
Yeah.
The African saying says, if there is no enemy within, the enemy outside can do us no harm. That the battles that we are facing in the outside are nothing compared to the battles we have in the inside. Remember the quote that we shared last time of Robert Wolf Emerson? He said, what lies before us and what lies behind us are tiny matters as compared to what lies within us. But if we are able to control these internal boiling pots of emotions in the inside of us, we are able to deal with other people in an intellectual manner. We are able to engage in fruitful conversations. We are able to engage in empowering relationships. Only and only if we are able to control what is the inside of us. You know, most people, any day of the day, when you call them and give them a platform to say a thing, they are not going to say anything besides something that is inside of them. When you take a water full of still water and the bottle and you squeeze it, the only thing that can come out of that is the still water, not orange juice, not Coke. So most of us, inside of us, we have boiling pots of emotions, and some of those emotions are anger, some of those emotions are insecurity, some of those emotions are of jealousy. And when we are pressed anytime at workplaces, at our businesses, what we express is what is inside of us. The Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Whatever that is full in your heart, the mouth speaketh. So that's why people normally say, be careful of people that you are always around, who wish you failure under the weight of, I'm joking, who wish you lack of progress, who speak death into your life under the weight, I'm joking, Chomi. It's not that. You know, remember, Sean likes to talk about spelling, that words are powerful, that anything that is said in your life manifests if you accept. So stop accepting degradation, stop accepting, you know, devaluing in your life under the people hiding under the issue of, no, I'm just joking. So you are in control. Self-regulation is being able to control the internal world. And as you do that, and each every person, when they do that, we are able to control what is in the outside. My number is 74776196. You are amazing. Go out there and do amazing things.
Right, Mompoloki. Catch you next week, Tuesday.
Thank you.
5:57 on our Tuesday station. Of course, it's been good. It's been lovely. Lina Getato Zandela Bao. Of course, the show is called The Plug. Till we meet again tomorrow, have yourself a beautiful one. I'm leaving you with Sam Smith, Fire on Fire. Good day.
My mother said I'm too romantic. She said you're dancing in the movies. I almost started to believe her. Then I saw you and I knew. Maybe it's 'cause I got a little bit older. Maybe it's all that I've been through. I'd like to think it's how you lean on my shoulder and how I see myself with you. I don't say a word, but still you take my breath and steal the things I know. There you go, saving me from out of the cold. Fire on fire, we're normally killers, but there's much desire. Together we're winners. They say that we're out of control and some say we're sinners, but don't let them ruin our beautiful rhythms. 'Cause when you unfold me and tell me you love me, look in my eyes, you are perfection, my only direction. It's fire on fire. It's fire on fire. When we fight like lions, but then we love and feel the truth. We lose our minds in a city of roses. We won't abide by any rules. I don't